Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alamin, and the rest. So that we have, everything is unison. So that alone tells me that the Quran is giving the right guidance. But the Bible has given birth to not less than 1,000 churches, which tells me, I mean, it beat my imagination. But I can see that he spent much of his time on it. So if you would advise Abdul Razak to follow suit. Thank you.
You get these books of mine, you know. There's a pamphlet is available, take it. You have my name and address. You know, I think they have the pamphlets here, anybody who wants it. And you can write for this literature of ours. Inshallah, he'll be able to help you in your work. Yes.
We now come to the last question.
Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to ask my question, in fact, which was related to my first question. I want to know the status of Christ as the prophet when he will come again.
I don't know what you actually have in mind, but if I'm right, that in his second coming now, will he be as a prophet enacting new laws and new regulations? If that is what you have in your mind, then I says no. You see, once you qualify, you become a BA, you become an MA, Master of Arts, that is your title. When you come and you start from kindergarten again, that BA that you have acquired or MA you have acquired, that title can't be taken away from you. You had earned it. So Jesus Christ is Jesus Christ. He still remains Jesus Christ. He is a prophet, but he's got no jurisdiction in this new dispensation. This is the dispensation of Muhammad. No prophet, new or old, can come along and contradict anything that has been said already in the Quran, because the Quran, Allah tells us in the Quran, Al-Yawma Akmaltu Lakum Dinukum. This day I have perfected for you your religion. If you believe that, we believe that. That Islam is perfected that day. Finish, no more. We don't need anything. We don't want Jesus to come along and tell us, now you can eat the pig because it is now brought up under hygienic conditions. Or now you can drink a little because look, everybody is drinking anyhow. And dancing is common. So I can't tell you can't dance because then we all run away from religion. And everybody is committing adultery. So what can I say? No, no. Whatever is laid down here is finished. Absolutely. Nothing can be added to this, nothing can be deleted from here. So whatever his status, he is the Messiah, we can't take his title away. He was Rasulan ila Bani Israel, you can't take that title away. He's there. As long as the Quran is there, the title remains. So in his second coming, he is still Jesus. But he's got no power. See, like a king, he abdicates. A new king takes his place and this man comes again. He's a king. He was King Richard the Lion-hearted, but he's got no say. Am I right? The one that's ruling now, his law prevails. Now man is the king, and a dozen kings from the past comes along. There are no kings, but the king title remains. Sultan so-and-so, king so-and-so, Messiah so-and-so, but he's got no power. He's got no power to change the law that is current. وآخر الدعوان أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
I would like to thank you all. As Brother Didat said yesterday, let the book speak. And when the book speaks, all humanity and all creation listens. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل الحمد لله وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى الله خير أما يشركون أمن خلق السماوات والأرض وأنزل لكم من السماء ماء فأنبتنا به حدائق ذات بهجة ما كان لكم أن تنبتوا شجرها أإله مع الله بل هم قوم يعدلون أمن جعل الأرض قرارا وجعل خلالها أنهارا وجعل لها رواسي وجعل بين البحرين حاجزا أإله مع الله بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء ويجعلكم خلفاء الأرض أإله مع الله قليلا ما تذكرون أمن يهديكم في ظلمات البر والبحر ومن يرسل الرياح بشرا بين يدي رحمته أإله مع الله تعالى الله عما يشركون أمن يبدأ الخلق ثم يعيده ومن يرزقكم من السماء والأرض أإله مع الله قل هاتوا برهانكم إن كنتم صادقين I'll say the same thing in English for those who don't follow Arabic. It is one way of rendering it. As you know, it is very difficult to translate Quran into English. All translations are just one way, a possible way of saying a few things of what is in the original Arabic. Say, praise be to Allah and peace on his servants whom he has chosen for his message. Who is better, Allah or the false gods they associate with him? Or who has created the heaven and the earth? And who sends you down rain from the sky? Yea, with it we cause to grow well-planted orchards full of beauty and delight. It is not in your power to cause the growth of the trees in them. Can there be another God besides God? Nay, they are people who swerve from justice. Or who has made the earth firm to live in, made rivers in its midst, set thereon mountains immovable, and made a separating bar between the two bodies of flowing water? Can there be another God besides Allah? Nay, most of them know not. Or who listens to the soul distressed when it calls on him, and who relieves its suffering and makes you, mankind, inheritors of the earth? Can there be another God besides Allah? Little it is that ye heed. Or who guides you through the depth of darkness on land and sea? And who sends the winds as heralds of glad tidings going before his mercy? Can there be another God besides Allah? High is Allah above what they associate with him. Or who originates creation, then repeats it, and who gives you sustenance from heaven and earth? Can there be another God besides Allah? Say, bring forth your argument if you are telling the truth. Thank you very much. I give the floor now to the chairman for the concluding remark of this series of lectures.
Brothers and sisters, I think we have heard enough and we have got enough within ourselves to contemplate upon. May God bless this evening, these evenings. May He, capital H, guide our hearts, forgive us our sins, bring us together, and make the best day of our lives the day we meet him. Brother Didat, you are leaving tomorrow for Umrah. Please pray for us there. Goodbye. Happy landing. God be with you. God bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Peace be upon you.